Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me? I'm just glad you've decided to watch this video with me. Now, today we are going to take a look at a feature that's built into iOS 8. And it's one that I probably should have been a little bit more aware of before, but the bottom line was I didn't really pay much attention to iOS 8 till I got my big new iPhone 6 Plus, which I still am quite enjoying having. So today we're going to be talking about instant notification stuff on iOS 8 through the use of widgets. Yes, indeed. Android users aren't the only people with widgets. iOS has widgets, not quite as accessible as in the Android world, but widgets is widgets today on Dotto Tech. Yes, indeed, all us poor iOS users who have not had access to widgets in the past now have access to widgets on our iPhone as long as we're using the latest operating system, iOS 8 or above, if it's there is an above when you watch this video. Now, widgets are a really cool idea. They are basically almost like applets. If apps are junior versions of applications, then widgets are junior versions of apps. They're one farther down the totem pole. But they are kind of always running in the background in instant access to the core information that an app is delivering to you. And we've had them for a while in the Android world. For example, when I'm using my Android phone, I love the EverNote widget, which gives me instant access to create new notes and things like that. And I am now starting to play with widgets in my iPhone. Now, Apple decided in their wisdom not to make widgets available on the home screen. So when you look at your main screen of your iOS device, it is not going to have widgets on it. You get to your widgets by swiping down into the notifications area, and for reasons known only to Apple, they've decided to put all of the widgets under the Today tab in notifications. If you go into the notification side, that's just notifications. It's in the Today side. And how you actually access them is here by tapping on the edit. Doesn't seem to be another quick and easy way. I looked in the settings and it didn't look to me like there was an easy way to get to it. Perhaps there's an easier way and you guys can mention it in the chat area below, but for the most part, you have to go in through the actual screens that you're gonna be working with. Now, this is now my notifications window or my widgets in my Today part of notifications. And you can see that I actually haven't configured it very much. I've got reminders in the calendar, which are, I believe, defaults. But down below, it's got a list of all of the apps that are installed on my iPhone that are widget friendly or WF. So widget friendly apps include things like Sunrise Calendar, which I want to include. So I hit the plus key and you see Sunrise Calendar has now moved up. See, I don't want the regular iOS calendar because I use Sunrise, which combines all of my different calendars together. So I'm putting that there. I don't use the Apple's reminders, but instead I use, there it is. But instead I use Todoist as my main task and my main task manager. So as you can see, I can go through and you can add the appropriate widgets to your own notification center. So now that I've done that, I will be getting notifications from those apps. Now, what are the best widgets? This is going to be a trial and error thing. You're going to have to go through, add widgets that you want to use. There, I see it within my widgets. Oh, good. It's got my to-do list available to me. Look, I'm looking at it right away in Todoist. So there I can say, oh, I already did that. So there it was 94 days ago. I did it, I guess. But there you can check things off right in it. So it's got your tasks. So they're going to be instantly accessible to you. And of course, the place that they're accessible to you is going to be when you swipe down into your notification center. And there's all of the Todoist tasks and the Sunrise tasks. If we go back in, just one last thing is you can edit the order that they appear, the priority that they appear, top to bottom in the list by just clicking and sliding them thusly within the manager. I think this is, as I say, a trial and error thing. You're going to have to try out your own widgets, see which ones work best for you. And I'll be experimenting with all the new apps as I go along. I'll be seeing which one of them I might want regular access to in the widget. So it's going to be, it's good. So finally, we are now a widget friendly OS. Those of us in the iOS world, we join our Android brethren in the world of widgets. That's it. I hope you found today's video to be useful. Remember, there's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first, please subscribe to this channel so you get notification of all of our cool videos as they come down the pipe. Second, if you subscribe to our newsletter, you will learn about all of our upcoming live events. We do a couple of webinars a month on a variety of different topics. You might want to join us. The best way to make sure you are notified is by joining our mail list. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel. We're supported by you, the people who watch our videos, through the crowdfunding site Patreon. Drop by our Patreon page, take a look, and see what's involved in supporting Dotto Tech, because there are benefits to you beyond just the steady flow of content coming from Dotto Tech. Oh yes, indeed, we do have perks that you can read about if you visit our Patreon page. That is it for today. I am Steve Dotto, still grateful that you stayed with me till the end. Till next time, have fun storming a castle.